Yon, what's up mga kaibigan? Tayo ngayon nagbabalik ano, upang magbigay na naman ng panibagong kalaman sa ating mga mabubuting mag-aaral. Ano? Gamit ang ating whiteboard marker, ang ating whiteboard itself, at syempre yung ating eraser. Ano? So ayun, bago tayo magsimula, bago natin ilahad ang ating lesson ngayong araw, no? Kung maaari lamang mga kaibigan, ano? Kung maaari lamang, mag-subscribe na kayo sa ating channel, ano? At ganun din naman, click nyo na yung ating notification bell para naman updated kayo sa mga lessons na ating i-release sa mga susunod na araw, ano? And also, syempre, para masayang lahat, comment, like, and share our videos para naman makatulong tayo sa iba. Alright? So, ayun. Good luck, guys! Okay, guys. So, today, we will prove trigonometric identities. So, now, we have a given trigonometric equations. Then, we will prove that the other side, no, yung nasa left side, ay equal dun na sa right side. Or vice versa. Okay, so ang kailangan lang natin gawin mga kaibigan is ma-prove natin that they are equal. Okay, that is proving trigonometric identities. Let's say, for example, number one mga kaibigan, ano? Let's start with the easy one. Let's say secant x minus cosine x equals sine x multiplied by tangent x. Okay? So, when we say proving trigonometric identities, we'll make sure that they are equal. Okay? So, it is either yung left side yung galawin natin or yung right side. So, kahit alin dapat doon ang galawin natin, at the end, mag-equal sila. Okay? So, let us, for me kasi, no, hanapin ko yung madaling gayahin para yung kabila yung gagalawin ko. Let's say, for example, between these two, para sa akin, ito yung mas madaling gayahin. So, ito yung aking gagalawin. Alright? So, pero again, sabi ko nga, kahit alin naman dyan yung ating galawin, basta mapag-equal natin sila. Okay? So, ito yung gagalawin ko, yung secant x minus cosine x. Okay, so let us apply some identities mga kaibigan. Ano? As you can see on our left side, this is secant x. So, we can apply a reciprocal identity here. Ano? Alam natin that the reciprocal of secant x is cosine x. Tama, ano? I mean, 1 over cosine x. Therefore, secant x is equal to 1 over cosine x, no? Minus cosine x. Then, let us simplify this one. So, let us have, or let us find the LCD of the two functions, no? Since 1 lang naman ang denominator na to, therefore, our LCD is cosine x. So, let us find the numerator. That is done by dividing the LCD to each denominator, then multiply by the numerator. Now, cosine x divided by cosine x, that is 1. Multiply by 1, that is 1. Okay? Then, cosine x multiply by cosine x, that is cosine squared x. Now, minus, kasi yun yung kanyang operation. Okay? So, from here, we can apply another identity. No? So, from our numerator 1 minus cosine squared x, we know that our trigonometric, our Pythagorean identity is sine squared x plus cosine squared x equals 1. That is our Pythagorean identity. So, if we transpose cosine squared x on the other side, no, ang mangyayari is sine squared x equals 1 minus cosine squared x. So, remember, tinranspose natin itong cosine squared x sa kabila, naging 1 minus cosine squared x, which is our numerator. Therefore, this is equal to sine squared x. Okay? So, palitan na natin yun ng sine squared x all over cosine x. Okay? So, ngayon mga kaibigan, from here, alam natin ito yung kailangan natin gayahin eh. Tama? So, ngayon, since meron tayong sine x dun, ano, paghiwalay natin yung numerator. Diba, dalawang sine x yan. Sine x multiply by sine x. So, paghiwalay natin yun, that will be sine x multiply by sine x all over cosine x. Okay. Eh, alam natin mga kaibigan na ang sine x over cosine x ay equal sa tangent x by quotient rule or quotient identity. Okay? Therefore, this is equal to sine x multiplied by tangent x, which is the right side of our equation. Tama, no? So, equals etong right side, sine x, tangent x. Gets? So, they are equal. Na-prove natin that they are equal. That is what we so-called proving trigonometric identities. Okay? So, sabi ko nga kanina, kahit alin sa magkabilang side yung galawin natin, dapat mag-equal sila. So, let us try to manipulate the right side. Tingnan natin kung mag-equal siya sa second x minus cosine x. Okay, so, burin lang natin ito. At yung right side naman yung ating imamanipulate. So, burin lang natin. Okay, so yung right side naman, ano? Sine x, tangent x. So, ang pwede lang nating ma-apply na identity yan is the quotient identity, ano? Dun sa tangent x. So, that will be sine x multiply by sine x over cosine x. So, if we multiply the two expressions, we have sine squared x over cosine x. Tama? And we all know that sine squared x is equal to 1 minus cosine squared x equals 1 minus cosine squared x over cosine x. Okay, now, since we have only one denominator, ano, isa lang naman yan, monomial lang yung ating denominator, we can divide each term, ano. Kumbaga, paghihiwalay lang natin yung 1 minus cosine squared x, magiging 1 over cosine x minus cosine squared x over cosine x. So, that will be 1 over cosine x minus cosine squared x over cosine x. Okay? Since we have cosine x sa denominator at merong tayong dalawa sa numerator, cancel na yung isa sa numerator, then cancel na yung denominator natin. Now, applying the reciprocal identity of 1 over cosine x, that is equal to second x minus cosine x na lang yung natira dito, which is our left side. So, they are equal, no? Second x minus cosine x. So, we prove that they are equal. Okay, so again, sabi ko nga, kahit alin sa sides yung ating galawin, walang problema. They must be equal. Example number 2. Let's say we have 1 plus sine theta over 1 minus sine theta minus 1 minus sine theta all over 1 plus sine theta equals 4 sine theta second squared theta. So that is our given 1 plus sine theta over 1 minus sine theta, etc. Okay, ngayon, sabi ko nga, ako kasi pipili ako nung side na mas madaling gayahin. Okay, so ito yung mas madaling gayahin, so ito yung aking imamanipulate or yung gagalawin. Okay? So based on the given here, kailangan lang natin tong masimplify. So let us find the LCD. Okay? So the LCD here is the product of the two denominators. So we have 1 plus sine theta multiply by 1 minus sine theta. Okay, that is the product of the two denominators. Then let us find the numerator by dividing the LCD by the denominator, then multiplying the into the numerator. So ito, divide mo dyan, so matitira to, multiply mo dun. So 1 plus sine theta squared. Yan. Minus yon. So ito, divide mo dyan. Matitira to. Multiply mo doon. So, magiging 1 minus sine theta squared. Okay? So, pag pinag-multiply natin to mga kaibigan, this is a special product, mga kaibigan. So, kapag minultiply natin yung denominator, no? So, isabay na natin na ito. Expand na natin yung numerator natin. 1 plus sine theta squared, that is equal to 1. So, square mo yung first term. So, 1. Tapos, multiply mo yung dalawa. So, 1 multiply by sine theta, multiply by 2. So, plus 2 sine theta. plus yung square ng last term, which is sine squared theta. Okay? Then, ito naman, expand din natin to. So, minus square ng 1, so 1. Then, multiply mo yung dalawa na yan, then twice. So, minus 2 sine theta. Tapos, square ng last term, which is sine squared theta. Yan. All over the denominator. Sabi ko nga, special product to. Multiply mo lang yung first term, so that is 1. Ano? Then, multiply mo yung second terms, minus sine squared theta. Yan. So, ngayon, simplify lang natin yung numerator. So, pag sinimplify natin yung numerator, magiging 1. Remember that meron tayong minus doon, ano? So, magiging, kapag ito, minultiply ko na, no? Minultiply ko itong minus or yung negative dito sa loob ng ating parenthesis. So, magiging 1. Ito, magiging minus na to. Okay? So, tatanggalin ko na yung para hindi na tayo mag-next line. Kasi, hindi baka hindi magkasya dun sa ating board. So, i-distribute ko na yung negative, ano? So, negative minus positive. So, magiging minus na yon. So, negative multiply by negative, magiging positive na to. Then, negative multiply by positive, so magiging negative to. Yan. So, remember, kaibigan, dinistribute ko lang yung negative sign sa parenthesis. So, that should be on the next line, no? Pero, hindi ko na nilagay. Baka kasi hindi magkasya sa board natin. So, simplify natin, no? So, 1 minus 1. So, 0 na yon. So, cancel na yon. Then, 2 sin theta plus 2 sin theta. So, magiging 4 sin theta. Then, sin squared theta minus sin squared theta, cancel na yon. Tama? Then, yung ating denominator, 1 minus sin squared theta, applying our Pythagorean identity, this is equal to cosine squared theta. Okay? So, ito ngayon ay equal sa cosine squared theta. Now, since ito nga yung ginagaya natin na 4 sin theta second squared theta, meron na tayong 4 sin theta, tama? And we all know that the reciprocal of cosine squared theta is 1 over second theta. Therefore, this is equal to 4 sin theta multiplied by second squared theta. Second squared theta, which is our right side. So, na-prove natin that they are equal. That is how we prove trigonometric identities. Another example, mga kaibigan, ng number 3. Example number 3, let's see, we have secant y plus tangent y all over cosecant y plus 1 equals tangent y. Okay? So, again, mas simple to. So, ito yung aking i-manipulate para maging kamukha nito. Right? So, base dun sa ating given, ano? Secant y, we can apply reciprocal, and then quotient. Okay, so apply natin, ano? Secant y is equal to 1 over cosine. Plus, yung tangent y, that is equal to sine y over cosine y. All over, yung cosecant natin is 1 over sine. Plus 1. Yan. Plus 1. Okay? So, ngayon mga kaibigan, mas maganda siguro kung pa ganun yung gawin kong solution, no? Kasi hindi magkakasya kung patayo lahat. Equals. So, ito, simplify natin yung numerator. We have a common denominator, tama? Cosine y. So, add lang natin yung ating numerator. So, magiging 1 plus sine y over cosine y. All over, the LCD of our denominator is sine y, ano? Sine y. So, sine y divided by sine y, that is 1, multiplied by 1, we have 1. And sine y multiplied by 1, that is 1 plus sine y. Okay? So, ngayon mga kaibigan, from here, ano, since we have a complex fraction, kunin natin ng reciprocal ng denominator. I think, kaibigan, kasya naman. Diyan mo na nga, sige. Kunin natin reciprocal ng denominator, then multiply natin sa numerator. Okay? So, ito yung numerator natin, 1 plus sine y over cosine y. Kapag kinuha natin yung reciprocal nito, mapupunta lang sa numerator ito, so magiging sine y over 1 plus sine y. So as we can see, ano, we have 1 plus sine y on the numerator. Meron din tayo sa denominator, so cancel na yan. Ang matitira na lang is sine y over cosine y. So sine y over cosine y. Tama? Which is equal to tangent y. Now, which is yung ating given. Yun. Therefore, napag-equal natin sila. Okay, that is how we prove trigonometric identities. Sa ganitong klase ng problem kasi mga kaibigan, napakahalaga na kailangan kabisado mo yung identities. The Pythagorean identities, the reciprocal, the quotient identities, the fundamental identities, etc. Kasi, you cannot prove, ano, you cannot simplify trigonometric identities kung hindi mo kailangan, ay hindi mo kabisado yung mga identities from our previous lesson. So, kailangan, again, make sure that you memorize, no? O kaya naman kung hindi memorize, meron kayong hawak na notes, no? Regarding the identities bago kayo makapag-prove ng trigonometric identities. So, yun lang mga kaibigan, no? That's it for today. That is how we prove identities or trigonometric identities. Stay tuned for another tutorial next upload natin mga kaibigan, no? So, God bless and mabuhay kayo mga kaibigan.